Hi all, Hal here with more 7 Days to Die Zombie Apocalypse. Anyway, happy Friday everybody, hope you're having a fantastic day. Oh, just looking forward to the Imperion live stream tonight at 7 US Pacific. We will be here on YouTube this evening. And as you can hear, it is now the non-running zombie time. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to go head over. Why? Dude, ever since they updated this, this thing is like completely broken. Frustrating. Anyway, so what we're going to do is we're going to head over to the radio tower. We're actually going to do a short stop over at the new bunker area. And we are going to drop some stuff off, and then once we've dropped stuff off over there, we're going to move over to the bunker, or over to the radio station. Oh, so you know it is early for me. I think everybody knows I tend to pre-record these a little bit. Today I'm running a little bit late, or I should say this week I'm running a little bit late. I'm still settling into my new personal work schedule, not so much the recording schedule. And, yeah, so it's something like sometime between 1:30 a.m. my time. So in less than 12 hours, this thing will be up and published for everybody else to enjoy. So anyway, let's get to it. So, yeah, been having a lot of fun with the new alpha. I don't know if anybody's been watching or not, but for the Imperion, the new Imperion alpha has been released last weekend to, you know, a bunch of the folks that are regulars on it, including a lot of YouTubers. Oh, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt. That's bad. yeah, but including a lot of the YouTubers. So there's been a bunch of us doing reviews and previews on some of it. So if you haven't checked it out, you might want to go do so, especially if you like the Imperion's game. The series itself has been a lot of fun for me, and I really appreciate the folks over at Ilion Games for letting me have access to it so early. So we're going to drop off most of this stuff. I am gonna actually, let's go ahead and let's say 10, right? Go ahead and craft 10 of those. I'm gonna craft one of those to take with me. Okay, so let's go ahead and drop that off. We'll keep those. We're gonna go ahead and drop those. Keep that. That is out of ammo. We're going to drop that stuff off. We definitely don't need any shovels while we're over here, and we shouldn't need a hammer. So, I think that is pretty streamlined at this point. We're taking the torches in the chest, so in case we find ourselves in need of light and storage. I'm really tempted to go ahead and say, use the... come on, get up. Thank you. Alright, so now, where do we want to try and break into the place? So I could actually just do... you know what, let's just do the blocks. Don't need the bone shiv. I could probably have left that here, but that's okay. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and do a couple of blocks. And perfect. Do some searching out here, see what we've got. Hopefully we'll come up with some good stuff. I hear somebody making some noise somewhere. Alright. Whoa, hello. What the... Something exploded. All right. Let's go ahead and finish looting up these cars. And one of the reasons why I wanted to get such an early start on the recording in the day today was because of the fact that, you know, we wanted to make sure we had plenty of time to come through, break into this place, make sure we looted everything up. And you definitely want to be checking the trash. I have been finding all sorts of good stuff in there, including schematics, and as you saw there, brass, which is one of the hardest things to find right now in this game. Alright, so that's gonna go away. Alright, I hear zombie. I don't see zombie, but I hear zombie. Alright, so let's go. So yes, that is a way in there. Hey, look at that. He's being nice enough to come on, buddy. Hey, buddy. How you doing? Okay, so that's the metal one. That is not good. Okay. Go ahead and break that out. What we're gonna do is get up, dude. What is up with these zombies block? Look at this. Get out my way. Sheesh. You know it's bad when you have to chop up the corpse. Okay. Thank you. Sheesh. Okay. So now that we are in, let's see what we got in here. A new puffer jacket. Puffy jacket. Hey, look at that. Wow, lots of puffy jackets in here. Considering we are in probably one of the warmest biomes outside of the actual burnt biome. Oh, let's put you in here. We're just going to put all you in there. Alright, and now this is leading over. Ooh, that is. That is some dark stuff. So this should be leading over there. Okay. I have to say this is pretty nice actually. Oh. Anything good? Okay, so I think what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead. Let's put our secure chest down. Oh, I don't know. What, right here? Sure. Alright, so let's go ahead and start dropping off all of the miscellaneous junk. Okay. So now we can come back, grab all this. And that's everything, right? Yes. Okay. So now we can drop the rest of this off again. Alright. Alright, so let's do a little bit of looting. Oh. One of the notes. Alright. Let's go ahead and put one of these over here. Now, can we actually get over that, or is that. Nope. So what we're gonna have to do is, oh, that's gonna take a while. Oh, see, this is why I wanted to get an early start, is because I knew we were gonna have to break through things at various points. And I have a feeling this is the reinforced concrete equivalent, I think. Well, we'll find out shortly. It might actually be faster to take the desk out. Alright, awesome. Okay, so if we ever need... So what we're gonna do is put some lights up in this place so that we can see. Because I am never a fan of bases that you can't see where you're going. Okay. See? Nice and bright now, right? Not nearly as gloomy as it was. Oh, and we got a ladder going up there. It does make you wonder. Oh, hello. What is that? Cobweb. Interesting. Empty corpse. Okay, so we're not going to worry about everything else up there. This should be... Yep. This place. And nothing over here really worth worrying about. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and close that off. And I think we're going to go ahead... And at some point, we're going to come back and actually reinforce all of this. But for now, we're going to leave it like that. So in the case, we do need to make a quick escape out that way. But as you can see, we have plenty of light down here now. All right. Let's go through all this. We've already got the... No, didn't get that one yet. Okay. Okay. Well. Yeah, we know there's stuff in there. So let's head on upstairs here. Go ahead and take a look through. See if we've got anything over here worth worrying about. Just because we want those to be closed. Oh yeah, we got some food issues. All right. Now the reason I'm closing the windows off as we go is because there are some weird detection abilities that the zombies have. And basically what ends up happening is that if you have open windows, even if they normally can't see you, they can still kind of detect you. It's really odd. Alright. But, yeah. Okay, so our bunker is over there. Our base is over here. Alright, so that's actually a really small... And just because I really don't like having... Really don't like having the corpses around. Because you just never know. One day, there's going to be this one day when you walk in... And Mad Mole's gonna have that bloody wake-up code that he's been talking about for a while. Basically, it's the zombies that you find, or corpses that you find, actually may not be just corpses. Alright. So, our bunker is due east. We have cleared out everything over here. We're going to go ahead and, like I said, we're going to go ahead and close this stuff off again. And what we're probably going to end up doing is taking most of this apart. The consoles like this, when you find them, they're actually really good for wire as well as lights. So if you're ever looking for it, you find these types of bases. This is basically where you want to be in order to get this stuff out. You know, especially for like the scrap metals, wire, and like I said, the lights. Alright, so one of the things that I do want to do is we are going to... So let's go ahead and make another frame really quick. Oh, I dropped off all my lumber, didn't I? Doesn't that just figure? Man. Did I get... I have no lumber on me, really? That's just silly. Okay. Oh, let's see. I think we get wood for that, right? But not for that. Okay. Hey, look at that. Perfect. Of course, if I place these, I should be able to get over that. Okay. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and place this. What I'm gonna do is head back over to the other bunker. Well, I'm gonna head over to the bunker, I should say. And we will get our stuff going over there. I do have to do a little bit of renovation on that place, and I'm thinking that may be pretty much it for today. I do have some more spikes we're gonna put down. Let's go ahead and drink that. We will drop that. See if we can speed eat these a little bit. Come on. Get us back up into the 30 percentile range. 40 may. Well, you know what? Let's go ahead and take it up to 50. Because we do need to have enough food that we're going to be able to start healing. And while I'm doing this, let's go ahead and we're going to use that. That does help with the healing factor. Just to make sure we don't have any zombies sneaking up on us, because, well, you know me, I'm paranoid. Because I think you need to be in the 75-80% range to start healing. The auto healing from having a high level of food. We shall see shortly. How's that? Okay. So we did end up having a dog horde yesterday in game. I was out and about doing some hunting. I was able to, for the most part, miss them. So it was kind of nice because of that. However, I did pretty much get my butt handed to me by them at one point, so... Alright. But we were able to get our stuff back. I was going to record it, and by the time I had everything set up to record, it was pretty much done and over, so I was just like, yeah, you know what? Not really worth it at this point. But that's okay. So I figured we would show everybody the raid process on this. Alright, can we... Alright. Okay, so... We do have the 7th day horde coming in tomorrow in-game. We've got Zomberts over there. Alright. but they are not over here, and that is what I am worried about. So that is a good thing. I don't mind them being over there. I do mind them being over here. All right, so let's see here. We're gonna go ahead and... Okay, so this is gonna give us 3 all the way around. Let's go ahead and pick up the stuff. Get this out of here. And at this point, it really is just getting the spikes and things down in place to start setting up to defend the Seventh Day Horde, because I do not think I want to be over at the little wood bunker area, the temporary base we had, for the Seventh Day Horde. So what we are going to do is I'm going to go ahead and finish setting this place up. I'm going to start moving my goods over here because I do have a bunch of food over there. Basically all of the meat and stuff that I've been holding on to. For anything that I could, I went ahead and converted it over to bacon and eggs. Everything else I then converted into grilled meat. We've got, I don't know, something like 30 or 40 goldenrod. We've got another like 20 or 30 red tea. Basically what I had done, and the reason why I had run into the dog horde, is because I was out trying to pick up snow to make bottled water. How many more of these we got? We got plenty. Alright. Now, I should not be generating too much heat here. And when I say heat, I am talking about body temperature. And not the heat map heat. Alright, so... Yeah, so what we're going to do is let's head in. How far out is that? That's 1, 2, so I do need to do at least one more here. Okay, so that gives me 2 or 3 on this side. That gives me 2 officially. Okay. This will be 3 officially. And like I said, what I will be doing is inside the base over here is basically a little bit more of the same. I'm going to be placing a couple of rows of these spikes down and around the... thought I heard something. But yeah, down and around the area of the tower. Okay. And that gives us so very much space. Probably should not have been doing that with those spikes in place, because with my luck, I would have dropped them directly in front of myself. So what I'm going to be doing for the rest of today and probably the first half of tomorrow is getting the rest of this cobble in. I do need to go ahead and take out the rest of this field. I'm going to take the car out, and then we're going to start, you know, basically replacing all of this with cobble as fast as possible. So I'm going to go ahead and call this episode here. I have a whole lot of clay digging to do, so I'm going to get out of here. I hope you all have a fantastic day. Thank you for stopping in today. I do appreciate it. If you have any questions or comments, make sure you leave them down below the section below the video. If you enjoyed the episode, I do ask that you hit the like button, as well as consider subscribing, because these are the 2 nicest things you can do to a YouTuber. Well, outside of giving us beer, money, or food, so... this doesn't cost you anything, and it's easy to do. Anyway, we are out of here. I hope you all have a fantastic day. Hope to see you back here tonight for the live stream at 7 p.m. I do need to drop off a whole lot of stuff here and start getting things organized. So I'm going to take off. I hope you all have a great day. And as always, folks, take care and be safe out there, everybody. So much stuff to drop off. No, this is, so wait, let's go ahead and read this. Oh, it's that one. Yeah, I don't want to go do kill missions yet. Time to reinforce the bunker.